you are welcome this morning. Good morning. Happy Friday, everyone. Shabbat Shalom. Let's worship the Lord this morning.
Lift it tonight.
Of the 21 nights of revival, and I feel the victory of the Lord. I feel the strength of the Lord. I feel the grace of God. I sense that the Lord is well pleased. Oh, hallelujah. And I just feel like giving God thanksgiving and praising Him and glorifying the King of Kings because of what He has done. This week has been such an intense week of bringing forth the new thing in the earth. Beloved, I'm telling you, birthings are messy. Birthings can be bloody. Birthings can be real tiring. So that's how I felt this week. But glory to God, we are on day number 5 of the 21 nights of revival. Day number 54 of the 100 days. A lot of dates, right? Oh, hallelujah, and I sense a victory. We made it through the week. We made it, we made it, we made it, we made it, we made it through the week. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And I just return all the glory. We return all the glory to God. We return all the glory to the King. I thank God for every speaker. I thank God for every watchman that prayed. I thank God for every house of prayer that entered into the global church. I thank God for every one of you, every intercessor, every friend, every prayer partner, every person that stood with us in this birthing, the bringing forth of this global revival. I thank God for you. I thank God for your labor of love. Oh, hallelujah. So much victory is in the house this morning. I'm releasing the sound of thanksgiving. I'm releasing the sound of victory. I'm releasing the sound of praises this morning. Why don't you help me to praise the Lord? We've come so far, and all through the power of prayer and intercession. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. The Lord have brought the nations together. The Lord have brought watchmen together. The Lord have brought the seers together, the prophets together, the messengers together in one place to corporately worship the Lord every night for 21 nights. Oh, Rabakasata Kayata. Only the Lord could do it. Only the Lord could do it. Only the Lord could have done it. Look what the Lord have done. I return all the glory. Ha! Hallelujah. You are holy. You are worthy. You deserve all the glory. We return all the glory to you, God. All the honor belongs to you. Hey, Santa Carabaca Santa. He is the miracle worker. The God that answers by fire have answered us. Hey, Santa Carabaca Santa. Worthy is your name. Holy is your name. Righteous is your name. You have answered us.
Hallelujah to Jesus.
The God that answers by fire, he is still the miracle working God. Look what the Lord have done through the power of praying men and praying women. Every morning that we gather here and we kneel at our prayer altars and we kneel at this place of prayer, we have been interceding for 1 million souls. We've been calling on heaven to hear us and to answer us. We've been asking the Lord to awaken the gatekeepers of nations, to awaken the watchmen of nations. We've been saying, Lord, let there be 1 million souls. Let the mighty men of valor arise. Let the mothers of Zion arise. Let the Esthers of their generation arise. Well, the Lord has answered us. Look what the Lord has done. Day number 54 of 100 days of prayer, and the Lord has answered us. Let the Lord be magnified. Let the Lord be praised. Receive all the praises. Praises to you. We exalt you, mighty God, because of you, who you are. You have heard our prayer and attended unto our needs. Our supplications have entered into your nostrils, and you have granted us the request of our lips. Father, we are so thankful. We are so thankful that you have heard us and you have answered us. Oh, Sata Karabaka Sata.
Come on, lift your voice.
The Lord has answered us. On this day 54, we are a living testimony of what the power of corporate prayer can do. And just as the Lord has answered me, the Lord has answered you. And I want you to get ready all through this weekend. Let it be a weekend of thanksgiving. Let this weekend be a thanksgiving weekend for you. All into next week, just give thanks. Just give the Lord thanksgiving. Just give the Lord thanks. Praise his name, bless his name, glorify his name because of what he has done. He has answered us corporately for the nations, and he will also answer us privately for our personal prayer requests. So those of you that are here, those of you in the global church, those of you that are gathered every morning, every evening, 10 a.m., midnight, whatever your time is with us, God is answering you personally. Because he answers from the head first. The oil flows from the head first. So just as he has answered us corporately, he's going to answer you and me personally. Every single thing that we need personally. Personally. Personally, he has answered us and he will continue to answer you. So we're just giving God praises and thanksgiving. Oh, Rabakasata Kayata Tatabakasata. So much has been done through the power of prayer. Beloved, as a mother, as a spiritual mother, I'm telling you, I've been carrying the miracle promises of God in my womb. I've been carrying the nations in my womb. I've been carrying the birthing in my womb. And I feel as though we have given birth to so many great things this week. Now that we have come to day number 5 of the 21 nights of revival, I feel such a release. I feel a release. I feel a grace. I feel a refreshing. I feel a renewal. I feel a settling. Oh, Rabba Kasata. I feel a stirring in my spirit that we have just begun. But it's going to get easier because there is unity. There is camaraderie. There is strength in unity. There is protection in unity. There is advancement in unity. Oh, hallelujah. Such a great victory has come to the people of God. And this is a corporate victory. So it's your victory and it's my victory. Because as I always say, when the kingdom of God advances, we advance. Everyone advance. When God wins, everyone wins. When the kingdom advances, everyone advance. So may you receive divine advancement. May you receive your advancement today. May you receive your divine advancement today. When the kingdom of God advances, all of the body of Christ has advanced. So we all have advanced. Glory to God. God bless you, Pastor Shanti. Pastor Shanti, I had a powerful, powerful banquet dream with you. I'm not sure if you're still on, but I'm going to share this dream with you. We were at a banquet. We were getting ready to do some sort of wonderful food Thanksgiving or something like that. And I came, right? And you said, Apostles, you sit here. I have prepared this seat for you. You sit here. And you had this beautiful seat around the table. And we all were sitting around the table. And I said, wow, this chair is so nice. Probably you should let someone have this nice chair. And you said, no, Apostle, this chair is for you. I prepared this place for you. You sit here. And you allowed me to sit at this really nice seat around this table. And you had all this food on the table. And it was like some sort of Thanksgiving or something. And there was glasses of wine for everyone. And the table was filled with foods of all description. So in the dream, you said, go ahead, Apostle Anna, pray and bless everything and let's eat. And that was the dream. So I just released that blessing on your life. The table is prepared before you. It's a banqueting table. The table of the Lord be prepared before you, Pastor Shanti. A new blessing is coming your way. A new victory is coming your way. A new grace has come to you today. May you receive that blessing on your life in the mighty name of Yeshua. Amen. Father, we just thank you for every intercessor, every gatekeeper, every watchman, every prayer warrior, every person that is connected to this prayer room. We thank you, Lord, for the new thing that you're doing. We thank you, Lord, for the advancement. We thank you, Lord, that there is a new grace and a new glory and a new strength has come to the burning ones. The burning ones. The burning ones have arisen. The burning ones are blazing with fire. The burning ones are riding on the waves of glory. The burning ones are opening their mouth and sounding in the alarm. The burning ones are running and running with enthusiasm. The burning ones, the messengers of fire, the messengers of truth, the burning ones. I release that grace on your life as you open your mouth and you have released the sound. As you have released the sound, your miracles are being framed by your sound. Your victory is being framed by your sound. Your advancement have come because you have opened your mouth and you have released a sound. You have released a sound in the earth, a sound of praises, a sound of victory, a sound of advancement. You open your mouth and you release the sound. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. I'm telling you, That's what happens when a people are come together in unity and in agreement. We open our mouth and we release a sound, and every Jericho wall must come down. Every Jericho wall must collapse. Every Jericho wall must be dismantled. When the children of Israel walked around those walls 6 days and six nights, and then on the seventh night they shouted, the Jericho walls came down. Hallelujah. The Jericho walls are coming down. I hear the Lord say, somebody's Jericho walls is coming down. Somebody's Jericho walls is about to collapse. Whatever you felt was keeping you back and holding you back, the Lord would say to you on today, the Jericho walls are coming down. Hallelujah! As we shout, it's a shout of victory. It's a shout of advancement. It's a shout of blessing. It's a shout of praises. When the praises goes up, the blessings come down. The praises go up and the blessings come down. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Well, I want to share this this dream that Prophetess Gems Glory had with all of the watchmen that have been connecting. This is a blessing for every one of us. Prophetess Gems Glory had a dream that someone was distributing stuff or blessings on a bus. And a bus always signifies a ministry moving forward. A bus signifies advancement. A bus signifies people of God moving forward in the things of the Lord. So she said we were on a bus and there was someone distributing blessings. And the person was giving all of the intercessors these bags of blessings. It looked as though it was money, earthly money. And when she received her blessing, every one of you, you all were receiving those blessings. This is Prophetess Gem's glory dream. And she said, when she received her bag of money and she opened it, it turned out to be a bag with, on the front of the bag, there were flags of nations. And there was some sort of reward. It was like a heavenly reward inside of that bag. And she said, every single intercessor and every single watchman that have connected to us were on that bus, watchmen and people from the local church, they were receiving this bag. She said, and the bag was filled with flags. There was flags of nations. And we all took it and received it. And I believe that represents a promotion in the spirit for every watchman and for every gatekeeper, for every auntie, uncle, mommy, daddy, every man of God, every woman of God that have connected to this altar for this 100 days of prayer. So the flags represent an unlocking of nations. Many of you, you're getting ready to travel into new regions. Many of you, you would not even have to travel for your voice to get there. The Lord have unlocked new territories for you. The Lord have unlocked new nations for you. The Lord would say to you, get ready. Your promotion have come. Your promotion have come. Global promotion. Receive global promotion. Receive global promotion. A new day, a new gateway have opened. The gates have opened, and it's gates for nations. Receive your global promotion. Receive your bag. Receive your bag of honor, your bag of victory. Promotion has come to the faithful intercessors, to the faithful gatekeepers. Watchmen that are faithful, those of you that have been found faithful, those of you that have stood with us and prayed and really pushed and labored in the vineyard, receive your promotion. Oh, hallelujah. Woo. I'm telling you, global promotion. Every person received that bag. It's a bag. And on that bag had flags and flags of all nations, all different nations and all different colors. And every person were receiving bags with flags on it. And so that represents global advancement and promotion. So I just speak that blessing over your life this morning, and I decree the favor of the Lord. I decree the increase of the Lord. I decree the advancement of God. I decree the establishment of the Lord. Those of you that are called to do businesses, if you're into business, you're on the mountain of business, I just speak over your business this morning. Supernatural prosperity, divine prosperity, increase. A new level of increase comes to you. New customers from different nations. A new level of partners. New partnerships are coming. New increase have come. New prosperity have come. The Lord will prosper your ways. The Lord will prosper you in your business. The Lord will grant you favor with the wholesalers. The Lord will grant you favor with the banks. The Lord will increase your portion with your U.S. accounts. The Lord will grant you an increase. The Lord will grant you easy access to the U.S. accounts in the banks to be able to purchase supplies and to be able to purchase your general merchandise. Wholesalers will grant you favor. There will be no backup, no delays, no closed doors. The Lord will open every door that is necessary for your growth and your development and for your advancement. I decree and declare, the Lord will take good pleasure in your prosperity. The Lord will take pleasure in your prosperity. The Lord will take pleasure in your advancement. The Lord is the one that takes pleasure in the prosperity of his servants. I speak that over your life. It will be easy. It will be an easy blessing. It will be an easy promotion. Not that it is easy, like an easy of just not doing anything, but for all of the weeks and years you have labored and you have toiled, this is the divine moment for that supernatural leap of prosperity to come your way. So I just announce prosperity over your life. I announce divine increase over your life. I announce divine blessings over your finances. I decree and declare a supernatural growth, seven times greater. In this week coming, you will see a seven times greater increase, seven times more. If you were receiving $1,000 every week, you will see 7,000. If you were receiving 7,000, you will see 49,000. It's a seven times increase. Seven times more, says the Lord. Seven times more. I want you to multiply whatever you were receiving. Multiply by seven times. Seven times more, says the Lord. Seven times more. A thief has been caught, and the Bible says when a thief is caught, he must pay back seven times more. Seven times more blessing, seven times more increase, seven times more favor, seven times more blessing. Just as you have labored for the Lord in the vineyard of the Lord, just as you have given up your service spiritually, you have sacrificed your time, your hours, your prayer, you have given up yourself for the things of the Lord to advance the kingdom of God. Now the Lord will return that blessing to you. That's the way that the Lord works. When you give out spiritually, the Lord returns physically and tangibly to you. So the blessing is going to come back to you in a tangible way. Don't even worry about where it's going to come or who is going to bring it or how it's going to happen. This is what I hear the Lord say. I am the one that have called you to the watchtower to watch. So I am the one responsible to bless you. The Lord says, I always pay my bills. I hear the Lord say, I always pay my bills. The Lord says, I always pay my bills. And so I'm going to pay that bill for you. I'm going to take care of that rent for you. I'm going to take care of that loan in the bank for you. I'm going to take care of that bill that you've got to pay at the utility places. I'm going to pay that bill for you. I'm going to help you through. I'm going to pull you through. I'm going to give you the victory. I am the God that takes care of the righteous. I'm going to pay my bill because I always pay my bill, says the Lord. Get ready. The Lord will do it. The Lord will do it. Let the Lord do it. Thank you, Lord. doing it for us. Thank you for paying our bills. Thank you for taking care of every bill, every rent, every cable bill, every internet bill, every utility bill, every house note, every car note, everything that has to be paid, every tuition fees, every school fees, everything that has to be taken care of, Father. I just thank you this morning for taking care of it. I thank you for taking care of the people of God. I thank you for just moving in their lives in such a supernatural way. I thank you, Lord, that your Holy Spirit have empowered your people and we have advanced yet again in the realms of the Spirit. There is no stagnation in this ministry. We are all moving forward in victory, because when the kingdom of God advances, we all have advanced. We all get a part of the blessing. When God advances, we advance. So I just receive this blessing. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. And I say, thank you, Lord. Thank you for your blessing. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your favor. Thank you for your anointing. Receive the blessing. Receive that blessing. The blessing of the Lord makes rich and adds no sorrow. There is no sorrow. The blessing of the Lord make it rich and adds no sorrow. No sorrow. Oh, hallelujah. I want to say thank you to everyone that have been giving, sowing into the 1 million soul harvest. Thank you so much for giving and partnering with us to help make this 100 days of prayer possible. Thank you for those that are sowing into the 21 days of revival to help make it possible. You are sowing into the 1 million soul harvest. And just as you have sown your seeds, you will receive and you will reap of the blessings of the Lord, and you will reap of that harvest. So even now, I just speak the blessing on your life. As we get ready to close out this morning, I want to encourage everyone, those of you that want to give, you can give anytime. Give as the Lord lays on your heart. Let's continue to partner to make this revival a success throughout the nations of the world. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you for praying. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for partnering. Thank you for giving. It's because of your prayers, it's because of your labors of love that we are able to advance the kingdom of God in the earth. Well, everyone, that brings me to the end of this morning's prayer. And I'm going to be on tonight again with our special guest. So be sure to join us. Be sure to come on in tonight in the prayer room. And let's hear what the Lord has to say to the nations of the world. This is Apostle Anna saying, have a wonderful day. Have a joyful day.
Lift it tonight.